Some breaking news in eastern Oklahoma County. We want to go live to this is obviously Bob Moore, Chopper 4, John Welsh up there. Speeds excess 106 miles per hour. John, what can you tell us about this?
Yeah, right now we're showing you, it looks like a white Suburban or a Tahoe pulling a trailer. It's southbound, I believe, on Air Depot. Police are in pursuit of it now. He's pulling into a neighborhood here, Meg. Let me make a call real quick to approach, and I'll be right back with you.
All right. Thank you, John. And Meg, that as you saw, that car was pulling a trailer going 100 and something miles an hour.
That's what makes it so strange. We heard first speeds of 85 miles per hour, then 106 miles per hour. And again, it's on Douglas. Is that what they're saying? On Douglas.
We're going to get a check from John. It's been going on for a long time. It started out on Britton and Choctaw. It's moved all over the place. Why this person is running, we don't have any idea. We seldom do. And he said, oh my goodness, I tell you what, there's going to be something bad happen here.
Okay, look at this, going through that intersection.
Yeah.
Now, we're told police have struggled with trying to stop him because they can't use their normal maneuvers because of the trailer on the back of the Tahoe. So that's caused some problems. They're trying to reconfigure and, you know, figure out a way they can do that with the trailer on the back of that SUV.
Right, they can't use their takeout move there that they usually use. And again, you see, this is a two-lane street. And so you see vehicles pulling over as they see the flashing lights ahead of them. This chase has been going on for some time, and it doesn't look like it's going to go away anytime soon. John, you back with us? I know you had to talk to...
Yeah, I'm back with you, Kevin.
Okay.
Hey, we're on post. We're coming up on Reno southbound, and as you can see, we have Oklahoma City in pursuit. Coming up on the intersection right here of Reno, still southbound. Definitely a hazard to people if you're on post.
What?
Look at that guy, Kevin. He's outside of the back.
He let it go.
Yeah, there it goes. The trailer's
going into the median. And, you know, it kind of just opened himself up to be a TVI or a pit maneuver
here. Yeah, tactical maneuver now. Now they'll be able to perform that if they can get up close to him.
Well, John, that was something we haven't seen. Go ahead.
Kevin, I've never seen anything like that before in my life. I mean, that guy leaned out of the back. And, about had a wreck right here at the intersection of 15th. We're still southbound on Reno, 15th, the next intersection is a mile away. And you can see Oklahoma City is getting close. I'm sorry, Oklahoma County is getting close.
Yeah, they are, John. And you give us again the location. This is...
Where are you right now?
I'm at Post and 28th Street, still southbound.
Okay. So 29th Street
is... Right. Yeah, we're fixing across by the Carl Albert School.
Okay.
Any guess on speeds right now? He looks like he's flying, or he was.
I think John's... there's a lot of air traffic
down
right now. If you're just joining us, a person climbed out of the back window...
Or west.
Yeah, just hang with it, John, and we're going to hang with you here because we're expecting the police. Now they now have a better shot at taking out this driver because somebody climbed out the back
window.
Well,
I'll tell you what. Now we're in Midwest City. He's still going. It looks like Oklahoma County has almost terminated the pursuit, but we'll stay with him. And he's coming up here on pretty much the Tinker diagonal, basically.
A lot of traffic there too.
Westbound 29th. That was just past Post, is what we're being told.
Yeah, getting into a lot of traffic here, 5
he's
o'clock
coming up
traffic.
On another intersection, guys, right here at Douglas. Let's see, looks like he's going to go southbound. There you go, southbound on Douglas. Coming up to I-40. We'll try and hold a hover right here.
Coming up to I-40.
So we don't lose
this
him.
Does not look
there
like
goes.
It's going to end well. We hope no innocent people are injured in this. And this is what makes you so mad about these people who run.
Yeah, look at he's passing guys there on the on-ramp.
Right.
Well, it's, you know, just after 5 o'clock, the busiest time. It's a Friday. Just the timing here couldn't be worse.
So he's on Interstate 40 now, John. Is what it looks like. Mm-hmm. Looks like he got onto an interstate. That would probably be I-40 if he's heading west.
I-40 westbound.
Okay. All right, we're getting a shot. You see how that camera on that chopper worked so well. They were at one point almost three miles away.
But it looked so close.
Right.
I know. And just to recap, in case you did not catch it, they did have a trailer on the back of this SUV, but a man poked his head out.
A high-speed chase. Sky News 9 over the scene, and Jim Gardner with it. Jim?
Tell us where you are.
White SUV there. Now, this started with Oklahoma County. We are now westbound on I-40, just getting ready to cross just north of the runways at Tinker on the north side here. It looks like he's getting off on, I'm not quite sure what, he may be getting off Hudaburg Drive here. But he's gotten off I-40 westbound. We're still westbound here coming up. Now, we understand that this started with Oklahoma County. Now, he was pulling a trailer moments ago coming down Post Road. They were southbound on Post Road when he lost the trailer. It is now just the white SUV. We do not know, at least I haven't got that information, Kelly, on what this person is wanted for. But he is he's definitely not stopping for any reason, and he's definitely not, he really don't care about persons or property on the ground. He's just trying to get away, whatever he can do here. He's at the gas station right there, the Circle K. Now he's coming, he's going to be coming back northbound. He's coming back northbound. I'll try to get you a street here. We'll find out exactly where we're going here. I'll pick up the street. Let me zoom out here just a second.
All right, our live picture there. This is breaking news live in the Midwest area.
Okay, we're on Air Depot. We're on Air Depot going northbound on Air Depot.
Goodness.
Getting ready to cross. We're getting ready to cross. We'll be coming up to Reno here pretty quick.
Okay,
so we're northbound on Air Depot coming up to Reno.
Let's try to nail this down. This is Air Depot. He is headed northbound, folks, from basically Tinker Air Force Base, maybe coming up on Southeast 15th Street. If you guys can pull back and give us a little wider shot, we can tell for sure. And then the next cross street should be Reno. Let's see if this is 50. Is this 15th perhaps there, Jim?
Right now we just crossed 15th. He now is going to come westbound on 15th. Okay, just stay with him, Alex.
He is heading in the direction of Dell City, from Midwest City to Dell City on Southeast 15th Street, getting ready to go right in front of Rose State College. If that helps you locate it, he is on the north side of Rose State College, passing that now, and then on up to Sooner Road will be the next busy intersection. It's a bad area to be racing in a car, Jim.
Well, that's right. You're exactly right, Kelly. Now, we're going to be coming up here. We're westbound on Southeast 15th. We'll be coming up here to I-40 pretty quick, and we'll see what he's going to do here. I've been looking for police. I have not seen any police cars behind this white SUV, so I don't know. Well, we got him there. Here we are at the intersection here of Sooner Road. We're coming up the intersection of Sooner Road. There's two cops right there. They are blocking traffic. Very smart move right there, Kelly. Very smart move there, getting in front of these intersections and trying to block traffic, because this person is not willing to stop for any reason as he blows through these red lights and stop signs here.
And now on the wrong side of the road.
We'll see what he's going to do. He's still going westbound on Southeast 15th at this time.
Under I-40, folks. Now he's over in the Dell City area.
I'm still looking for police in the back, and I still haven't seen any police cars at this time, but he is still running at a high rate of speed, Kelly. Mm. He is not slowing down for any reason. He's just weaving in and out of traffic, blowing through the, you know, the only thing we can hope is that we don't get a head-on collision here, or he hits a car. But, oh, he almost got a car right there.
That's got to be Sunny Lane.
That's right. We just crossed Sunny Lane just now. We're westbound on Southeast 15th. Cross Sunny Lane. Now he's getting off. Now he's going to go into a neighborhood street here.
Oh, boy.
I'm not sure what that street is, but this is going south from Southeast 15th into a neighborhood street here. I'll see if I can pick it up on my GPS here in just a minute, Kelly, and tell you what street we're on.
Jim, just to give you a break from talking, folks, this is a chase that we have been following since over on the other side of Tinker Air Force Base. Went right in front of Tinker Air Force Base on I-40, got off on 29th, swung through Midwest City. He is now in a Dell City neighborhood. Started as a pursuit involving the Oklahoma County Sheriff's Office, and now Sky News 9, Jim Gardner overhead. Jim, is Air One involved in this, the police helicopter for Oklahoma City?
No, Air One is not on scene at this time. Right now, okay, I see a police car coming. He's way behind. He's about a half mile behind this car coming down this road right here. I'm not sure what road we are. He's just running everybody off the road, Kelly, through this neighborhood. He's not slowing up for any reason.
They don't see police cars like this, folks, is usually when we see them ditch the car and go out on foot. This guy hadn't done it yet, but this is what usually happens, is they ditch the car and try to hide. And fortunately, Sky News 9 is over the vehicle right now, and I'm sure OCPD and Dell City and Midwest City are monitoring our signal. And we can tell you, as you're watching this, that Sky News 9 is practically over the vehicle right now.
Okay, he's one block west of Sunny Lane. one block west Sunny Lane coming down this side street. It may be Karen Drive. I'm not, that's what I'm showing on my GPS, but I'm not sure if that's correct. He's just running through these neighborhoods here. Okay, now he's coming back on a little side street. He's going to be hitting Sunny Lane again. Let's see which way we're going. Okay, we're going to go southbound on Sunny Lane. Southbound on Sunny Lane.
Are you guys right in front of Del City High School there? Because we see speed zones.
That's correct. That's correct. And we had a Oklahoma County car just blocked traffic. He is turning around now. He's in pursuit here. He's about a quarter mile behind. Okay, now he's turning on another neighborhood street here that is coming back eastbound underneath me. We're going to roll around here.
South of Del City High School.
And he is coming around underneath me again. He's coming up to another side street. Okay, I'm looking
back north.
I'm looking up ahead. There's only this street runs back northbound. Okay, he's just going randomly through these streets right now.
And folks, as we're watching this, we're not sure why this guy is running or why Oklahoma County was after him. It could be some kind of a warrant they were trying to serve. But he is making no progress at all in getting away here in this neighborhood. This is just a few blocks south of Del City High School, and there's an officer right there. Mm-hmm. So far, we've been fortunate that he hasn't hit anyone, and we've also been very fortunate there haven't been any pedestrians out in these neighborhoods.
Well, he had no regard for any other motorists, stop signs, or anything, and now this is the first time we've literally seen a county sheriff car involved in the pursuit, very close behind, and this man has been going for the last 25 minutes or so in this pursuit. He's
there. You go right up, tilt up. There you go. There you got him.
Okay.
Now it looks like another law enforcement car is also in the pursuit, and you know, we're just hoping this has a safe outcome. Motorists have been, lives have been put in danger with this man on the roads.
Absolutely.
And he needs to get off the streets.
And that looks like
looks
a Del
like
City
a
officer.
Del City, it looks like we got a Del City police car involved here. Okay, now this street he's taking now runs into a dead end. It goes to the left or right. We don't know which way he's going to go here. Okay, he's going to come back to the right.
I'm telling you, he is cooking through those neighborhoods. I'd say he's hitting at least 50 or 60, Jim, through those neighborhood streets.
Oh yeah. He has absolutely no regard for person or property on the ground. If people in this area are listening to us right now, they need to get, if they have kids outside, anybody outside, they need to get off the street. Mm-hmm. Okay, now he's coming back up on Sunny Lane. We're going northbound on Sunny Lane.
Right by Del City High School, and I-40 will be just ahead, and this is where you start, you know, drive time home. This is a major thoroughfare in Del City, and this is where it can get very scary as he...
Ooh. Oh, he just, he's just skimming these cars.
Folks, this is afternoon rush hour in Del City, and Sunny Lane and 15th and 29th and all the way up to Reno. Those are very busy intersections. He's getting ready to come up on I-40 right under there.
Goodness.
Oh, my.
Right, we just crossed Southeast 15th, going northbound on Sunny Lane again.
And, of course, he's picking up speed, and this is what he has been doing. This is
the worst-case scenario, Kelly, that you know, he's, the way he's blowing through these intersections, I'm just afraid somebody's going to have a head-on collision. And that's definitely not what we want. Oh, he slid. He lost control there for a minute.
Oh,
he lost control right there on
there
the corner of the Conoco
just
station.
Just north of I-40.
There we go.
He's not going far.
Okay, he's on running on flat tires. You'd see he actually...
You wouldn't think he would be.
T-boned that post.
Boy,
right
he is
there.
Trying
this
to get away.
Wants to get away. This person wants to get away, but it's going to come to an end right here pretty quick.
And we need to...
They need to get him stopped before he kills somebody.
And we might want to widen the shot if this gets stopped, Jim. Just a little bit if this thing gets shut down.
Okay, he's running on flat tires on the back, and you can see he T-boned that
curb right
there.
Yeah, let's go ahead and push back in on it, guys.
So go ahead and zoom in there, Alex, just a little bit. We got sparks coming off the wheels.
Wow, that car is just disintegrating.
Well, that's right. It's you know, when he T-boned that curb there at the Conoco station, like I said, we're on Sunny Lane, still running northbound. This person does, I don't know what he's wanted for, Kelly, but it must be pretty drastic because he's not wanting to stop at all.
No, but we need to be careful if he does get out of the car. This is breaking news. You're watching it live, northbound on Sunny Lane in the Del City area, and this is going to come to a conclusion very quickly. And sometimes these don't turn out the way we hope. And
this is Reno, right, Jim?
We're on Reno right now.
All right, here we are.
He's going to give up right here.
This pursuit started near Choctaw about...
He's trying to run. I can't believe this. He's trying to run. Mm. This is absolutely ridiculous. You can see him trying to run at this time.
I suspect he'll be tasered here pretty quickly.
Okay, that
hands up. Now he's down on the ground.
All right, folks, this is the conclusion of a chase. The conclusion of a chase involving Oklahoma County Sheriff's Office, and I suspect they might have been trying to serve a warrant. This chase started all the way, we know, on the east side of Tinker Air Force Base, went past Tinker into Del City, through Midwest City, into Del City, wound around through neighborhoods. He finally crashed into a pole and continued on at Southeast 15th
and Sunny Lane
and
Road.
Sunny Lane back in that area, right under I-40.
Right in the middle of rush hour.
Boy, just so close to getting many people hurt.
Boy, Kelly, the only thing I can say about this is just pure luck that nobody got hurt in this. But I mean, it's a great thing because as many four-way stops and stoplights and everything that he blew through and didn't hurt anybody else, it's just a miracle. But Del City, Oklahoma County, and everybody else that involved this did a great job of getting this and getting it done. It's just a good thing that he lost control there on the corner there and T-boned that SUV, so it just couldn't run any further. He was running on flat tires on the rims, and the truck just couldn't go anywhere else, and they were able to catch him, which is good before he actually killed somebody. This was just crazy, Kelly.
Jim, anyone else in custody? Were there others in the vehicle?
We lost our shot. We know one thing. That man is being taken to the Oklahoma County Jail. We will know his name by 10 o'clock tonight and what they were, got the shot back now. It does look like, Kelly, you'd mentioned it. Were there anyone else?
The driver, and I guess, suppose this was a passenger because it was the driver that got out and started running.
We watched that.
Well, that passenger was on the wrong side of that car because you can see where it has been in. That's where he spun the car right into that pole. And that they're not acting like either one of them are injured, certainly not the driver. They're walking him to a police car, and the other one is down on the pavement, and they don't seem to be concerned about any injuries there.
No, and this actually, it is a blessing that no one ended up, as we watched this, holding our breath through the high-speed pursuit that was going on with the way this man was driving. And there he is. There's the man that was behind the wheel. We will know more about him as the evening progresses, and we'll let you know what he was wanted for.
Let's ask the control room while we get ready to go to break. Re-rack that video where he hit that pole at that gas station. We'll show the viewers that again coming up here in a few moments. Let's take a break. More to come on this in just a moment.